The name of this video is The Electric Circulation Case 2. So once again, we are going to study two dielectric materials, let's say amber and glass, separated by, let's say, an aluminum sheet with some surface sigma F charge density. And so, as always, let us sketch here the surface of separation in 2D between the two materials. Capital sigma is such a surface of separation, where again, here we can have a sigma free, as well as obviously a sigma p due to polarization. As before, this sigma free can be realized by placing a conducting material right at this interface, a thin, let's say copper aluminum foil right there with some sigma f, exactly as before. As before, we call 2 the material below in 2D, of course, this representation, and the material above is 1. And as before, below we can have a rho free 2 as well as a rho p 2, and above we can have a rho free 1 as well as a rho p 1 for complete generality. Okay, p doesn't have to be uniform, so we could have rho p 1 and rho p 2. We want to study what happens in the vicinity of a point capital P somewhere here on this interface. Case 2 as always. So this is capital P, the point of observation, which has nothing to do with the polarization vector intensity, again, as before. And so in this case, we want to study the local properties of, let's say, E, the electric field, for the circulation case 2. And so in order to do that, we need to define a cut-type line. And so the cut-type line will be something like this. Rectangle. In this case, note that this is not a cylinder, it's just a line. So do not confuse it as always with the previous case, which was for Gauss's theorem. In that case, we need a closed surface. Here we need a closed line because we are doing circulations. And so we start from point capital A, we reach point capital B, we then reach point, this is the oriented line, capital C, and point capital D. And from point capital D, finally, we reach point capital A. And this line here is what we call gamma cut, which is a closed line. Half of it is in the region 2 and half of it in region 1. So the height of this line, as always, we call it H. Half of H is above and half of H is below, region 1 and 2 respectively. The length of, let's say, AB, which is the same as CD, this is delta L, which is a physics infinitesimal, delta L. Okay, as always, the idea is that we want to squeeze it down to go really in the neighborhood of point capital P, so we will need to bring H to zero, as always. Before doing that, what are we trying to study here? We are trying to study the electric field, let's say E1 in proximity of point P, and down here there will be an electric field E2 in proximity of this point capital P. So note that for Gauss's theorem, I started directly with D. Why is that? Because D is straightforwardly connected to sigma F, only the free charges. In this case, it's a circulation in statics, which is going to give us zero, so it's better to start from E, which gives me a zero. Okay, so under these conditions, what else we know here, we, instead of defining an n unit vector, we need to define a t tangent vector, because we're looking at the tangent components. So if this is my t, tangent vector is the same as t1 in region 1, opposite of t2, as always, in region 2. Usual convention from 2 to 1, so 1 has to go as t, to opposite of t, unit vector in the tangent direction. Of course, there could be a lateral field EL We know nothing about any of them. You want it to an EL. But of course, when h goes to zero, this lateral contribution should vanish, it becomes negligible. So this is all we need in order to solve this problem. Now we want to squeeze it down to see the local property of E. And so how do we do that? As always, we bring h, that goes to 0 plus. So under these conditions, as always, when h becomes small, the lateral contribution is negligible. So we don't care about the lateral contribution. And in addition, t1 becomes exactly equal to t, whereas t2 becomes equal to minus t under these conditions. Okay, so the circulation of E, we know that the circulation along gamma cut of E dot TDL, electrostatic case, has to be equal to zero. So this simply means that since we have a very small delta L, which is a physics infinitesimal, if you want, it's a small quantity, okay, it's a small quantity, then obviously this becomes nothing but E1 dotted with T1, but in this limit is nothing but T, plus E2 dot T, of course, times delta L, but this becomes minus E2 dot T, because T2 is actually minus T, times delta L. This has to be equal to zero. So now obviously delta L can be eliminated from this equation. And so we find, as expected, the irrotational property of the electrostatic field in local form case 2, which is E1 minus E2 dotted with T equals zero, which equivalently we can also write in terms of components, tangent components after doing this projection. This effectively is nothing but saying that ET1 is equal to ET2, as expected already from these 242. Okay, so now that we know that, from the definition of D, as always, the free auxiliary vector is epsilon naught E plus P. From this simple definition, clearly we can find that already in components, dn dt, because we're looking at the tangent components in this case, circulation, so it's always then tangent components, sorry about that, dt1 minus dt2 has to be equal to epsilon naught et1 minus et2 plus pt1 minus pt2, but we know that epsilon et1 minus et2 is all equal to zero because of this property here, they are equal to each other, and so we simply find that the tangent components of D are as discontinuous as the tangent component of P, which makes sense because we already knew that the circulation of D is the same as the circulation of P. So to recap this video, the electric circulation case 2, circulation is better to start from E instead of D because we already know that the circulation of E has to be equal to zero from 242. So we set up the usual cut type line, which is along which we calculate the circulation. Part of the line is in region 2, let's say amber, part of the line in region 1, let's say glass, and there is some conducting material very thin in between these two dielectric materials, which are with some sigma F and of course some sigma P in the neighborhood of this point capital P. We don't know anything about the 1 and the 2, but we know that the circulation has to be equal to 0. So under the condition that h goes to 0 plus and a small delta L, we can say that the tangent components of E are continuous around capital P. Similarly, because of that, the tangent components of D have the same discontinuity of the first kind as the tangent components of P. That's it.